22 years ago, in 1992, Durham became the first new first-class county cricket club for 70 years. Durham was a magnet for players from all corners of the country, many disillusioned with their previous counties after years trudging the same path. They attracted iconic figures, Ian Botham, Dean Jones, Wayne Larkin, to name a few. The county itself is characterised by magnificent views and a loyal, optimistic population. The unparalleled support soon idolised favourite members of the team and revelled in their new identity. Behind the scenes, Durham were very quick to avoid the cumbersome infrastructure that so stifled the advance of the county game. Instead of delegating responsibility to committees, the club established a limited company, controlled by a board of directors. Thankfully, it left team selection to the new, well, those who knew what they were doing, Jeff Cook and David Gregney. The club's acceptance, though, into first-class cricket was made conditional on the building of a new Test match standard cricket ground. Work began on the new ground at the Riverside, a spectacular location overlooked by Lumley Castle when hosted its first game in May 1995. For a decade after gaining their new status, Durham were not distinguished by marked success. As a first-class county, indeed, in the 2004 season, they finished bottom of the second division, 6 out of 10 in the One Day League, and 5 out of 6 in the Northern Division of the 2020 Cup. However, in 2005, the team achieved promotion from both the second division of the county championship and the One Day League. During the 2007 season, Durham won their first major silverware here at Lords, the Limited Overs Friends Providence Trophy. A year later, Durham went on to claim the county championship for the very first time, retaining the title in the following year, 2009, and after going against all odds, winning the title for the third time last summer in 2013. In 2003, the Riverside Ground was raised to Test match status. Now known as the Emirates Durham International Cricket Ground, the county has a magnificent arena in which to play cricket, and one worthy for England to host an Ashes Test, where we won the Ashes last year. Durham has seen a number of their top players make an impact at international level for England. Stephen Harmison, Paul Collingwood, Liam Plunkett, Graham Onions, Philip Mustard, and more recently Ben Stokes and Scott Baldwin have all been selected to represent their country. And of course, will Ricky Ponting ever be able to forget Gary Pratt? With the area's record of producing pedigree players, astute management, and a purpose-built Test match arena, there should be plenty more success for Durham County Cricket Club in the future. Approximately 7 years ago to the day, in 2007, I had the honour and privilege of leading Collie's benefit year into battle. A battle in a year that saw the devastating start of the economic downturn. The irony that our final event was in fact in this room, where our guest speaker was the governor, the then governor of the Bank of England, Sir Mervyn King, who after his headline speech, All Things Cricket and No Things Economics, took great pleasure and delight in reassuring me that the worst of the economic crisis was over and almost behind us. He got that wrong. What also came as a surprise during that infamous year of raising awareness for Marie Curie Cancer Care and Cricket's Chance to Shine programme was the number of times I was challenged over why I was heading up a benefit year for a northeast lad when I was from the smoke. I love cricket, I love Durham County Cricket Club. I buy into their story and what they're all about and what they represent. The challenges, trials, tribulations this small club has faced over its brief history and time, coupled with the successes achieved on the outfield more recently, is nothing short of remarkable. Let us remind ourselves for a moment that cricket is not an international sport awash with the riches that other sports benefit from. County cricket clubs and the professional side of the sport that follows does not automatically lend itself to cash surpluses and profits. The support of the ECB and the interplay between the counties and the international setup is well documented and is indeed an ongoing issue. The county clubs must retain talent as long as possible, and as this is key to the on-field success. But when those players are lost to international duty for sustained periods, then sometimes the playing challenges can be insurmountable. The importance of cricket academies and the development of young cricketers all the way through the ranks is, however, fundamental. At the beginning of the evening, you heard from my very good friend, the Group Chief Executive of the club, David Harker. David and I share very common passions in fine wine and sport, but most importantly, in delivering a first-class product. The products of Durham County Cricket Club are deep-rooted, and you have heard this evening of many of those high-profile success stories from individuals who have carved their names into the North East Honours Board, Angels of the North East. We are humbled and privileged to be in this magnificent room this evening at the home of cricket. Lords, a place like no other. A place that has seen success for Durham County Cricket Club and its homegrown players, both the club and country. You have heard about the remarkable story of the club's county champion success last season, a story which clearly is not told by looking at the final 2013 championship table. A story that unfolded in very unfortunate and dramatic circumstances when Sir Geoff was taken ill. How amazing it is to have him here this evening recounting for us his story, and we look forward to hearing many more stories from him in the future. Financial difficulties and obstacles which are far easier to navigate if you are a London-based or surrounding counties cricket club. John Lewis, first team coach, stepped up last season under very difficult circumstances from his position as Rose 11 team, second 11 coach. Judgy, a former player himself, has also been instrumental, together with all the backroom staff, in ensuring a healthy production line of all talent through the Durham Cricket Academy. Academies and structures without the support of the likes of you and I, ladies and gentlemen, that patiently bear fruit at the highest level through performances, successes and trophies at county level, and also the deliverance of cricketers onto the international arena. Arenas and stages that we will watch, read about and admire. Durham County Cricket Club is in a place in a part of the world that my very close friends from the North East label as God's country. If you haven't had the opportunity to go to the cricket ground at Chester Street in the shadows of Lovely Castle and take in some cricket, the hospitality and the warmth of those involved in this wonderful setup, then you are truly missing out. Mention my name, I'm sure you'll be made to feel most feel welcome. We hear the expression Ross Brooks used a lot in sport, an expression or words that are nothing more than just words without a tangible and structured framework. In 2009, the Durham County Cricket Foundation was established. And since then, this has had an immeasurable effect and impact on thousands of people in the North East region, providing inspiration, motivation, and raising self-esteem to the local community using the power of sport. The foundation's programs are divided into various pillars of activity, being education, grassroots sport, health club, development, and social cohesion. The resources that Durham Cricket have put into this foundation, together with the interaction of tens of thousands of people, hundreds of schools and over 50 local cricket clubs, has meant this work the foundation does and the results produced have been positively quantifiable. Supporting grassroots sport, ladies and gentlemen, supporting grassroots cricket. Supporting it, being part of it, watching it grow, watching it flourish, being there to see it harvest, magical. My responsibility here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is to impart some of the passion I have for cricket and for this terrific club. To rally the troops, if you will, especially the southern softies amongst us. Friends, it is far too easy for us to take granted those things in life that we don't take a role in, join in, or play a part in. Tonight, I ask you all, I appeal to you all, please be generous, dig deep, continue or start to play a part in supporting the magnificent Durham Cricket Foundation, a first